Sure, you can hear me.
Okay, so I hear the echo now when I'm talking. So everybody mute. Can you all hear me? Okay. Carl is first, then Pat, Harvey, Murray, then Anna and Ray, Bob and Susan, Jerry, Bill, Pardon, Mike Reeves, Ed Trickett, and Lonnie. Okay, that's the order that we're going to follow. If anybody else comes in, they'll go after that. Okay, so without any further ado, we'll turn to Carl, who's going to start the show for us. Everybody else, please mute. Okay.
I'm going to do a tune called In the Rare Old Times, a little Irish song.
Oh, yeah.
If you've been to Ireland, you'll appreciate it. Ring a rosy as the light declines. I remember Dublin City in the rare old times, raised on songs and stories. Heroes of renown, the passing tales of glories that once was Dublin town. The hallowed halls and houses, parting children's rhyme, that once was Dublin City in the rare old time. Ring a rosy as the light declines. Remember Dublin City. My name is Sean Dempsey, as Dublin as can be. Born, heart, and laid in Pimlico, in a house that ceased to be. By trade, I was a cooper, lost out to redundancy. Like my house that fell to progress, my trade's a memory. Ring a rosy as the light declines. Remember Dublin City in the rare old times. And I caught it Peggy Dignan, as pretty as you please. A Rogan child of Mary from the rebel. To a student chap with skin as black as coal. When he took off to Birmingham, she took away my soul. Ring a ring a rosy as the light declines. Dublin City in the rare old time. The years have made me bitter, the gargle rims my brain. because Dublin keeps on changing and nothing seems the same. The Pillar and the Met have gone, the Royal Lawn since pulled down. As the gray unyielding concrete makes a city of my town. Ring a rosy as the light declines. Remember Dublin City in the rare. Sweet Anna Liffey, I can no longer stay and watch the new glass cages that spring up along the day. My mind's too full of memories, too old to hear new chimes. I'm part of what was Dublin in the rare old time. Ring a rosy as the light declines. I'll remember Dublin City in the rare.
This is going to Pat. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay. Everybody else, please mute.
Okay. So this first song is "I Can't Help It If I'm Still in Love with You."
Today I passed you on the street, and my heart fell. I'm still in love with you. Nobody else stood by your side, and it looks so satisfied. I can't help it if I'm still in love with you. A picture from the past came slowly stealing as I brushed your arm. Walk so close to you, and suddenly I got that old time feeling. I can't help it if I'm still in love with you.
Well, considering everything else that's going on in the world with, you know, arguments with the French and arguments with DeSantis and arguments with the doctors and just all this nonsense, I thought I'd do a Randy Newman song mocking it all. called Political Science. I think I don't need the capo. No one likes us, I don't know why. We might not be perfect, but heaven knows we try. All around, even our old friends put us down. Listen, the big one, see what happens. We give them money, no, they're grateful. No, they're spiteful, and they're hateful. Don't respect us, so let's surprise them. Canada's too cold. South America stole our name. Let's keep the big one. There'll be no one left to blame us. We'll save Australia. Don't want to hurt no kangaroo. We're building all American amusement park there. We've got surfing too. Set everybody free. We'll have Japanese kimono, maybe there'll be Italian shoes for me. They all hate us anyhow. So let's drop the big one now. Let's drop the big one now.
That's not a laughing matter.
Hilarious. I love your t-shirt, Harvey.
Okay, thank you, Harvey. Murray,
yeah,
all yours now.
Okay. All right. This is I have this book here, which gives songs of the gay 90s. That means most of the songs were made about in the 1890s, or some a little after, some a little before. But for the most part, they're, you know, like barbershop quartet songs and stuff like that. There's a couple of traditional songs in there too. And among them is the one I'm going to sing, which is The Yellow Rose of Texas. It was actually written by a black man, as far as I remember from other places. This book doesn't tell you anything about the origins of the songs, except for who wrote it, and if they don't know, they put down traditional. But you know, I think I've read that it was made by a black man, and they don't know his name. And he's singing about the yellow rose also being a black woman,
right?
Because he remarks in the chorus that she's the sweetest rose of color. But those words have been changed around often in Texas, which probably didn't care too much for them, judging by their temperament in Texas and the fact that they were part of the secession in the Confederacy. But anyway, that's what I know about it. So I'm going to sing the words that they have here now. There's a yellow rose in Texas I am gone to see. No other fellow knows her, nobody, only me. She cried so when I left her, I'd like to broke her heart. And if we ever meet again, we never more shall part. She's the sweetest little rosebud. Oh, actually it says the sweetest rose of color a fellow ever knew. Her eyes are bright as diamonds, they sparkle like the dew. You may talk about your dearest maids and sing of Rosie Lee, but the yellow rose of Texas meets the bills of Tennessee. Where's the Rio Grande is flowing, where stars are shining bright, we walked along the river on a quiet summer night. She said, if you remember, we're parted long ago. You promised to come back again and never leave me so. She's the sweetest little rose of color a fellow ever knew. Her eyes are bright as diamonds, they sparkle like the dew. You may talk about your dearest maids and sing a Rosie Lee, but the yellow rose of Texas beats the bells of Tennessee. I'm going back to find her, my heart is full of woe. We'll sing the songs together we sang so long ago. I'll pick the banjo gaily and sing the songs of yore. The yellow rose of Texas, she'll be mine forevermore. She's the sweetest rose of color a feller ever knew. Her eyes are bright as diamonds, they sparkle like the dew. You may talk about your dearest maids as sing of Rosie Lee, but the yellow rose of Texas beats the bells of Tennessee.
I see you want to go back to the regular chorus. Okay, that's the folk process, as they say. Okay, so thank you, and I believe next we go to, let me just check the list here. Okay, next is, we go to England, Anna and Ray. Can you hear us? It's your turn.
Yep, we're good.
Shine, and your two people get two songs.
Okay. Okie dokie.
I love being an alien. I love it.
Yes. Actually, I used to live in the USA, and I have an alien card still. It says got my picture and the word alien, just in case anyone doubted it. So we're going to start with a song by Pentangle. It's kind of two-thirds of a song by Pentangle. It's a very long, rambling song. You would all have fallen asleep by the time we finished. So we lopped out the middle bit. And we discovered that the lyrics made actually no more or less sense before the surgery than after. So we might as well just wade in and do it. Oh, it has a la bit, so please la along.
La 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 la
his unrequited love. A thousand days have come and passed, the Lord returns this night. The victor from the bloody wars has proved his force and might, as ever he would claim. But fate has played its wanton game, the circle come full turn. The magic horn has done its work, falseness is found out, the sorrowed quest is over.
La 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 la
la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la.
Got one more coming
for
you.
Okie dokie. I saw a video of that song at one point, and they said in the intro, this is a medieval heavy rock song. But actually, I strongly suspect that it was written within about 5 years of the next one that we're going to do, which was written, I think, in the early 70s. Because I think they just wanted it to sound medieval, and it really wasn't. But this next song that we're going to do is a song by one of my heroes, Joan Baez. And again, sing along if you know it. It's just that the moon is full and you happen to call. And here I sit, hand on the telephone, hearing a voice I'd known a couple of light years ago, heading straight for a fall. As I remember, your eyes were blue than robin's eggs. My poetry was lousy, you said. Where are you calling from? A booth in the Midwest. 10 years ago, I bought you some cufflinks. Can bring, they bring diamonds and rust. Seen already a legend, the unwashed phenomenon, the original vagabond, you strayed into my arms, and there you stayed, temporarily lost at sea. The Madonna was yours for free. Yes, the girl on the half shell could could keep you unharmed. Now I see you standing with brown leaves falling all around and snow in your hair. Now we're smiling out the window of that crummy hotel over Washington Square. Our breath comes out, white clouds mingles and hangs in the air. Speaking strictly for me, we both could have died then and there. Nostalgic, then give me another word for it. You're so good with words and at keeping things vague. Cause I need some of that vagueness now, it's all come back too clearly. Yes, I loved you dearly, and if you're offering me diamonds and rust, I've already paid.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thanks very much. Thank you for singing.
Thank you so much. Great accompaniment. Okay, Bob and Susan are next, and take it away.
Okay, I'm just here for the free ride today. It's just going to be Bob.
Yeah, it was good to hear Pentangle. I don't think we've had that in our collection since LPs, 33s. And every time we seem to get a collection of things, tapes, then they change it to CDs. Now the last car we got, there's no CD changer in it. Now I got to put everything on a stick. Progress, I guess, huh?
I just keep all the old recordings and the equipment to play them on.
We have room. We don't.
Anyways, I've had kind of a muscle strain in this arm all week, so I've been trying to take it easy on it. And so I haven't really looked into any new songs. So I pulled out a couple of old ones that I like. This one's a Stan Rogers song. A couple of his songs are about, you know, fishing villages that are going by the way because either running out of fish because of all the trawlers and stuff. And the young people are going to find where they can make more money, you know. This is called Free in the Harbor. Well, it's blackfish at play, Hermitage Bay, from push through across Ross Island. Beaver roach and they sprout, they eat their flukes out, they wave to a town that is dying. Now it's many the boats now glide on the foam, all the way. The whales make free in the harbor. Free in the harbor. Blackfish are sporting again. Free in the harbor. Untroubled by Cummins and Cummins of men who once did pursue them as oil from the sea. All in a the whales make free in the harbor. It's at Portage in Maine. You'll see them again on their way to the hills of Alberta. With lopsided friends, they waggle their chins and they brag of But it's a living they found deep in the ground. As doubts, it's best to ignore them or think on the bones, the crosses and stones of their fathers that came there before them. In the taverns of Edmonton, fishermen shout, haul it away, haul it away. They've left 800 years buried up by the bay, where the whales make free in the harbor. Harbor, blackfish are sporting again. Free in the harbor, no trouble by coming. Yeomans of men who once did pursue them as oil from the sea. Haul it away, haul it away. Amongst Paddlebury Rock, next to Hermitage Bay, where the whales make free in the harbor. Stan Rogers.
Yeah,
thank you, Bob. Okay, and next we go to Jerry. Are you ready?
Okay. Hope everybody's doing well. My wife and I got our booster shots today. I've never been so happy to be old. It was great. While I can still move my arm, I'll play some banjo for you. This is a tune I first heard played by Doc Watson. It was apparently recorded for the first time by Clarence Ashley back in 1929. And, like any good, respectable banjo player, it was about killing somebody. So. Little Sadie and I blowed her down. I went home, I went to bed, 44 pistols smoking under my head. Woke in the morning about 9:30. The hacks and the buggies all standing in line. Gents and gamblers standing around. Take little Sadie to the burying ground. I done thought my thoughts and away I run. Made a good run, just a little too slow. Overtook me in Jericho. I was standing on the corner reading a bill. Along come the sheriff of Thomasville. Says, young man, is your name Brown? Remember the night you blowed Sadie down. Yes, sir, my name is Lee. I murdered little Sadie in the first degree. First degree, second degree. If you have any papers, will you read them to me? They took me downtown and dressed me in black. Put me on a train and started me back. Crammed me back in the Thomasville jail. Had no money for to go my bail. Judge and the jury, they took their stand. Judge had the papers in his right hand. 44 days, 44 nights, 44 years at the ball and strike. Well, I went out last night to make my round. I met little Sadie and I blowed her down. I went home, I went to bed, 44 pistols sunken under my head.
My pleasure. It's England now and Bill Pardon.
Right. Good afternoon or good evening. Can you let me know if you can hear me clearly? But this thing I've got in front of me on the screen keeps saying low system resources affect audio quality, clear any outstanding apps. It's all right. That's good enough. Okay. Thank you. And I've just had another last minute change of mind seeing Terry Hiscock appear in his little corner there. So I think I might get away with this one. We did have our Hoyer Anchor 50th anniversary celebrations a year late yesterday. Tremendous success, but throughout the afternoon, we had over 50 performances from members past and present and all sorts of people coming together that hadn't met each other for years. There was a couple there of unexpected success. They got a rousing reception when they'd done their act. One or two of you might know them, but I think I was the only person there that they actually recognised, and it was quite emotional because I'd not seen them for years, and I had to do man hugs and everything, and I don't really know how to do man hugs, and I'm hoping I didn't sort of lift my leg in a sort of strange little fashion that ladies tend to do. But anyway, they were John and Di Cullen. I don't know if anybody else knows them from around the club scene. Terry knows them. Oh, well, he'll know just what I'm talking about then. And they reminded me of a song that they'd taken from me years back. They perform as part of a four-piece band whose name I can't remember, but they told me they're still actually performing it because it goes down very well. It's nothing like the way I'm going to do it, and it's not really designed as an unaccompanied, but it was a song, the only one of the few I can remember when I wrote it, because it was back in 2008 when they had one of these dreadful cyclones. This was Cyclone Nargis, and it made landfall in Burma, caused awful destruction, as they always do. But the thing that made this natural disaster stand out more than the others was that the fact that, you know, people were raising money all over the world, nations were sending aid. But of course, the Burmese government no way wanted to talk to any of the Western powers, and they were just haggling and arguing for weeks on end, and all the equipment and food and supplies were there, and they just couldn't reach the people because the politicians and the world leaders couldn't come to an agreement as to how they were going to get on. So this was a song I wrote as part of a fundraiser for that event. It's the only reason I can remember when it was. And if you bear with me, I'm going to tootle along with the harmonica because it's the only way I can always get some sort of a tune in my head to do it. But there we go. And I think the only person that might remember this could be Terry. But there we go. There's a little child in Burma sit crying on a hill. Never heard of McDonald's, never had a happy meal. Little child is hungry and frightened and ill. He's just a cyclone child. A little child searching through the rubble and the bricks might find some food or something useful he can fix. He never knew nothing about power and politics. Poor little cyclone child. Ho, ho, it's a funny way of living. Ah, should I laugh or should I cry? With so many people giving, just seems a funny way to die. It's a funny old world we live in. Don't even ask the reason why. Can there ever be any forgiving when they let the little children die? Don't worry, we got ships waiting out there off your shore. Don't fret, we got food and medicines galore. It's such a shame that our leaders don't talk anymore. Tell that to the cyclone child. If you don't want our help, that's for you to regret. There's lots of other letters in the victim's alphabet. We can move down the line and we'll soon forget the poor little cyclone child. Oh, it's a funny way of living. Ah, should I laugh or should I cry? With so many people giving, just seems a funny way to die. It's a funny old world we live in. Don't even ask the reason why. Can there ever be any forgiving when they let the little children die? I never want to preach about East versus West. I never believe that a one side knows best. I see them that's got it all cheating, them that's got less. And the cyclone child is crying while dictators speak out with their venomous prose. The prime ministers and the presidents, how they posture and pose, wearing their democracy like the emperor's clothes, while the cyclone child is dying. And it's a funny way of living. Should I laugh or should I cry? With so many people out there giving, just seems a funny way to die. And it's a funny old world we live in. Don't even ask the reason why. Can there ever be any forgiving when they let the little children die? And no, there can never be any forgiving when you've let your little children die. I nearly got it right.
That was amazing.
Very, very powerful poem. Okay. Thank you, Bill. Mike is next and then Ed. Okay.
Yep. Okay. Well, big news, huge news for me. Don't know about the rest of you, but I'm actually coming out to Florida November the 17th. I've been allowed in at last. So maybe I'll see some of you during the winter. Secondly, as Bill said, we had our anniversary yesterday. That was 11 hours of singing off and on in the choruses and things. Today we've been on the pier, commemorating the pier in the war. That was a couple of hours we did. So I'm not sure how much. I'm certainly only going to do one, and I'm not sure how this is going to go. Now, theme of Tuesdays, I've been doing things for Tuesday. Well, some friends from the choir, I composed a song and they put, or one might put some music to it. But I've done that here before, or at least they came on and did it with me. And then the other thing we did was Parking Glass, which I've also done. So hopefully this is one from the choir that we've been working on. Robert Burns goes way back. Car the yows, tae the nows, car them where the heather grows, car them where the bonny rose, my bonny dearie. Hark the mavis evening song, sounding Cluden's woods among, then a folding let us gang, my bonny dearie. We'll gae doon by Cluden's side, through the hazels spreading wide, o'er the waves that sweetly glide. Say the moon, say clearly, call the yows, say the nows, call them where the heather grows, call them where the bonny rose, my bonny dearie. Fair and lovely as thou art, you have stolen my very heart. I can die but cannot part, my bonny dearie. Call the yows, tae the nows, call them where the heather grows, call them where the bonny rose, my bonny dearie, my bonny dearie. Yeah, a bit quavery, but
thank you, Mike. Okay, Ed, it's your turn. We're glad to have you back. I know you're missing for a while, but whenever you do show up, we really appreciate it. So
it's good to be back. We were up in Maine visiting Nick Apollonio and Gordon Bach and old musical friends. It's nice to be back. This is a song that I actually heard Nick Apollonio sing up in Maine. He learned from Helen Schneer about the closing of the Valley Furnace mine in Pennsylvania in the late 1800s, and also the mine next door or nearby called the Shoe Fly, where people would go if they couldn't find work in the Valley Furnace mine. So this is just a song about that, written by somebody at that time whose name is not known to me. I went a-walking one fine summer's morning. It was down by the furnace I chanced for to stroll. Spied an old lady, I'll swear she was 80, at the foot of the dirt banks, a-rooting for coal. And when I drew nigh her, she sat on her hunkers, for to fill up her scuttle, she just had begun. And to herself, she was singing a ditty, and these are the words the old lady did sing. Crying out alone, oh, I'm surely distracted, for it's down by the Shoe Fly they cut a bad vein. And since they condemned the old slope at the furnace, sure all me fine neighbors must leave here again.
was only last evening that I asked McGinley to tell me the reason the furnace gave o'er. He told me the company had spent $80,000 and finding no prospects, they would spend no more. He said that the diamond, it was rather bony, besides too much dirt in the 7-foot vein. And as for the mammoth, there's no length of gangway unless they die land from old Abel and Swain. Crying, oh, home, sure I'm nearly distracted, for down by the shoe fly they cut a bad vein. And since they condemn the old slope of the furnace, sure all me fine neighbors must leave here again. But if God spares me children until the next summer, instead of a burden there will be a gain. And out of their earnings I'll save an odd dollar and build a snug home on the foot of the plain. Then rolling in riches, in silks and in satins, I ne'er shall forget the days I was so poor. Nor likewise the neighbor that stood by my children, kept want and starvation away from my door. Oh, crying at home, sure I'm nearly distracted, for it's down by the shoe fly they cut a bad vein. And since they condemn the old slope at the furnace, sure all me fine neighbors must leave here again. So if you should ever cross over broad mountains, come in and sit down in me cane bottom chair, and take off your fixings, lay them on the bureau, whilst I in the kitchen refreshments prepare. And while we are seated so snug at the table, enjoying the fruits of a strong cup of tea, we'll talk of the quiltings we had at the furnace, and it pleasures me greatly your neighbors to see. Oh, crying at home, sure I'm nearly distracted, for it's down by the shoe fly they cut a bad vein. And since they condemn the old slope at the furnace, sure all me fine neighbors must leave here again. And since they condemned all the slope at the furnace, sure all me fine neighbors must leave here again.
Never heard that one before. Must be a new one.
Good.
It's a great song though. Really great. Okay, Lonnie.
Melody.
Huh?
You heard the melody.
Yeah, it's Chris Laredo. Yeah, it's the same album. Yeah. A little variation on it.
Yeah.
Okay, Lonnie, are you ready for us?
Yes, but I'm ready for you. But are you ready for me? That's the question. There's a song about ships and about bad luck and hurricanes and storms and so on. Here we go. He was a fugitive with a pseudo name,
lost his mind in a hurricane. Coconut upside his head. People said he'd be better dead, 'cause his glory days are gone. Sits on the shore with his saxophone and plays. He was plays in another time. He was a soldier in his prime, on the battlefield making history. Young men died for his destiny, till their widows came each day, and he was forced to run away from home. So he bought a town and he sold the sea, claimed a shallow victory on an iron ship with a wooden crew. They hit the reef when the moon was new. Now he cries himself to sleep on the beach with the promises he meant to keep long ago. Nobody speaks to the captain no more. Nobody talks about the war. Hey, what the hell were we fighting for such a long, long time ago? And the monkeys and the iguanas, they listen to his song. A most uncaptive audience he plays to all night long. So the story goes, he was dressed to kill, and he jumped from the old mahogany mill. And the jungle beasts, they were heard to wail, and the saxophone still played the scale for a man we never knew, who looked like me and you so long ago. Nobody speaks to the captain no more. Nobody talks about the war. Hey, what the hell were we fighting for such a long, long time ago? Hey, Ben, thanks very much. Appreciate that.
Yeah, very good.
What was the name of the song and who wrote it?
Excuse me?
What was the name of the song and who wrote it?
The name of the song is Nobody Speaks to the Captain, and you're not going to believe who wrote it, but it was Jimmy Buffett.
Wow.
Oh, yeah. Wow. I don't have any trouble believing that.
Yeah, he's. I knew him pretty well when we were down in the Keys. It was an interesting thing one night. We played at a place called The Quay, which was on Duval Street, right across the street from the Pier House. And we played downstairs, and they had a little alcove there for us. And it was on the street level, and the windows were always open right behind us. That was the backdrop to the stage. And I did a Jimmy Buffett song. I think it could have been Margaritaville, because all the tourists loved that song. And everybody loved it, and I turned around, and there he was, standing there in the window, and he gave us a $20 bill. And at that point, I fell in love with him, of course. No, he was he's a nice guy. No kidding, you know. So, all right. Thanks very much for listening.
Okay, thanks for playing. Okay, Debbie and Ron, you're next.
Oh, Okay.
I'm ready for you. I hope you're ready for me. Anyway, Debbie, this calls for the fog machine. Debbie, turn on the fog machine.
Uh-oh.
Hey! Oh. Here I come, man, we wanna go home. Hey! Daylight come and we wanna go home. Work all night on a drink of rum. Daylight come and we wanna go home. Stack banana till the morning come. Daylight come and we wanna go home. Mr. Tallyman, tally me banana. Daylight come and we wanna go home. Come, Mr. Tallyman, tally me banana. Daylight come and we wanna go home. Lift 6 foot, 7 foot, 8 foot punch. Daylight come and we wanna go home. Lift 6 foot, 7 foot, 8 foot punch. Daylight come and we wanna go home. Me say day, oh. Daylight come and we wanna go home. A beautiful bunch, a ripe banana. Daylight come and we wanna go home. Hide the deadly black tarantula. Daylight come and we wanna go home. Lift 6 foot, 7 foot, 8 foot punch. Daylight come and we wanna go home. Lift 6 foot, 7 foot, 8 foot punch. Daylight come and we wanna go home. Me say day, oh. Daylight come and we wanna go home. Come, Mr. Tallyman, tally me banana. Daylight come and we wanna go home. Come, Mr. Tallyman, tally me banana. Daylight come and we wanna go home. Daylight come and we wanna go home.
Yeah. Very nice surprise.
I used to work for a banana importer, and we did occasionally get tarantulas that survived the journey over in the in the refrigeration in the warehouses.
All right, that was actually originally a Jamaican slave song, a subtype of work songs, and released originally in the 1950s by someone from Trinidad before Belafonte made it famous. Okay, so
I like the part about the tarantula.
All right, so here is a train song, which you remember from long ago, that it was let's see, what key is this? Anybody who lived in or grew up in Brooklyn in New York will especially relate here, as I did many, many decades ago.
Blackwood.
Train subways plenty of times going to Pace College back when it was 15 cents to ride the subway.
Me too, 15 cents. And that was my train, the IRT. It was made famous by Dave Van Ronk, written by his friend Lawrence Block.
Okay, Donna, are you ready for us? Unmute.
There you go. Okay. I want you to know I feel like I'm in the presence of such greatness. So many of you, so talented. It's just a joy to listen to you. I just love that Diamonds and Rust and just the way we play and the voices that I'm hearing. It's such a blessing. About 35 years or so ago, I was sitting with my kids in the, you know, I have little children and sitting in there, they had a big playroom and I was sitting there with my guitar and I started writing a song and it's called Children. And the first two words of it are children. And I thought it was gonna be about them. And I thought I was writing it for them, but as inspirational have it, it became something to just draw our hearts to realize that we're God's children and to just come to Him. And it's such a pretty song, and I hope you enjoy it and receive it.
Children,
as to me your hands you raise. Children, I love you as I listen to you sing. Hearts, as to my words you cling. Children, I love you, and I long to draw you near. Learn to stay close. My gentle voice you'll hear. I am the good shepherd, and I know my sheep, and they know me and know my voice. Obey and follow me. Obey and follow me. Okay. I'm going to have to keep going because I'm expecting company tonight. I'm expecting company in a couple of hours, but I just want to tell you I love you all, and it's just a blessing to be here as often as I can. Thank you.
You're really shocking, Gail.
Okay, next is the moment we've all been waiting for. Terry, take it away.
That was lovely. Yes, thank you. It was nice to be here. And I do apologize for arriving late. I've been stuck in traffic. There seems to be a problem with people getting fuel over here. And so there's queues all over the place, which held me up. The fuel I'm drinking here, I've just realized this is a beer from Shepherd Neame Brewery in Faversham, Britain's oldest brewery, and it's called 1698, which is when the brewery was founded. I'm telling you all this because I've discovered it's about 8.5% in alcohol, and I've drunk that much of it, so I might not get to the end of the song, but I'll do my best. It's a song I wrote a long time ago for a friend in Cornwall who was going on his travels. It's called Dave's Song, and his name, by sheer coincidence, was Dave. Will you be leaving your family and friends? Those you've known for so long. The wood's on the fire and the bolts in the door. Come away from the window, it's a cold wind that blows on the moor. And will you be needing your compass and shoes? You who've traveled so far. And must you be going to a land far away, when the true word of welcome is spoken right here every day? Thank you.
must be leaving my family and friends, those I've known for so long. The grass beneath my feet, well, it's growing so fast that I must be leaving while the feeling inside me still lasts. Farewell to my neighbors, my friends near and far. Farewell to them all, but I will return to the land of my name, and they'll all come to see me and welcome me home once again.
Really beautiful. And I have the honor of always of following the best performer in the house somehow. So I got stuck with it. We'll do our best. Okay. This is a song which is, it's a very inspirational song. It's written by someone who's not very well known in the general folk world, very well known though in the Orthodox Jewish community. His name is A.B. Rottenberg. And he wrote a song about two twins in the womb. Okay, and it's known that some twins sometimes that had mental telepathy, you know, they could like talk to each other. And A.B. wondered what happens when they're in the womb, can they somehow communicate with each other? And his imagination brought him to write this song. Now, the song was always strictly in the beginning, never moved out of the Orthodox community until Jerry Wisentowski decided to record it on his album, Lucky Break. And he sang it together with Tim O'Brien. And this song is sung actually by two people. So I'm gonna have to do two parts. So I'll hold up one finger for part one. I'll hold up two fingers for part two. It's not a very long song. And but Jerry did it like with a bluegrass beat, which was very good because when A.B. originally did it, it was like very slow. But Jerry really jazzed it up well, so we'll try it, okay?
Bluegrass stuff.
Well. Yeah, he bluegrassed it very well. Okay. These are two twins talking to each other. The first one is the pessimist, the second one is the optimist. My dear brother, look around me and tell me what your eyes behold. Don't deny that you see it's only you and me. Our existence, it is empty, it is cold. Our existence, it is empty, it is cold. But dear brother, you must have faith that we are not the only ones. For in the distance, there's a place where we'll stand up tall and straight. Oh, I believe there is a world to come. Yes, I believe that there is a world to come. My dear brother, don't be blind, don't be stubborn, don't be sad. Imagination is all right, but it won't light up the night. What you see is exactly what you get. What you see is exactly what you get. But dear brother, you will surely find when all is said and done, that the future it will show, there is so much we don't know. Oh, I believe that there is a world to come. Yes, I believe that there is a world to come. My dear brother, where have you gone? Is this the moment I have known? I can faintly hear the cry, my dear brother must have died. It's all over now, forever. I'm alone. It's all over now, forever I'm alone. But dear brother, don't mourn me when my life has just begun. For what you hear are sounds of joy. Congratulations, it's the boy. Oh, I believe that there is a world to come. Yes, I believe that there is a world to come. Cause what you hear are sounds of joy. Congratulations, it's the boy. Soon you'll be here with me in this world to come. Soon you'll be here with me in this world to come. So now we're going back to the beginning again. Second round, Carl, you're it. Everybody else, please mute.
Can you all hear? Yeah, I'm on. Okay. Well, there's a song or two about the sea, so I'm going to do a song about the sea called The Rolling Home. Call all hands, the man in the capstan, see the cable running clear, heave away. Times we spend together, happy times we spent with you. Rolling home, rolling home, rolling home across the sea. Morning, and our sails were full of snow. Clear your sheets and sway your halyards. Swing around and let her go. Up aloft amid the rigging blows a wild like a moon song in the springtime, filling out each well-known sail. Rolling home, rolling home, rolling home across the sea. Rolling home to old New England. falls behind us many thousand miles before. Ocean lives, a wind's to bring us to that well-remembered shore. Rolling home, rolling home. The sea rolling home to old New England, rolling home to Atlantic.
Yeah, Phil and I have just been singing that on the pier.
Say again.
Bill and I have just been singing that this afternoon on the pier.
Well, come on over here and English. Do it over here too.
The English version of it.
We'll do it together down in Key West.
Okay. Pat, you're up for it.
We just got back from Key West.
Yeah, we did. We went to Key West. It was lovely. So, this song is just you and I, and it's a duet.
Just you and I, sharing our love together. I know in time we'll build the dreams we treasure. It'll be all right. Just you and I. Just you and I,
just you and I, sharing our love together.
I know in time,
and I know in time,
we'll build the dreams we treasure.
We'll be all right.
Just you and I,
and I. Just you and I,
we can
trust each other.
You in my life,
with you in my life, there'll never be another. We'll be alright. Just you and I.
Up my fingers here. See if I can get them to work properly. Something by Gordon Lightfoot, early Lightfoot. Well, I got my mail late last night, a letter from a girl that's found the time to write to a lonesome boy somewhere in the
that I had. Sent me a railroad ticket too, to take me to her loving arms, and the big steel rail gonna carry me home to the one I love. Well, I've been out here many long days, I haven't found a place I call my own. Not a two-bit bed to lay my body on. I've been on a stuck-up, I've been shook down, I've been dragged into the sand, and the big steel rail gonna carry me home. Most every night, walking around the streets of this old town. Not a friend around to tell my troubles to. My curdled car, she done broke down, cause I drove it into the ground. And the big steel rail gonna carry me home with the one I love. Well, look over yonder across the plain. Big drive wheels are pounding along the ground. I'm gonna get on board and I'll be homeward bound.
There's another song from that book about songs of the gay 90s. Like I said, it's not strictly the gay 90s because some of them are a little earlier and some of them a little later, but around that period. And this one is a song that everybody knows, but apparently nobody knows who wrote it originally. That's why it's called traditional. And it's the song, "There is a Tavern in the Town." Now, one of the stanzas is very much like stanzas in a lot of other songs, including Barbara Allen. So, some of those songs that are popular, some of the stanzas that are popular, get shared among many other songs. All right, you'll hear it when I sing it. Put on my close-up glasses. Okay. There is a tavern in the town, and there my dear love sits him down, and he drinks his wine mid laughter free, and never, never thinks of me. Fare thee well, Loyal, I must leave you. Do not let the parting grieve you, and remember that the best friends must part. Adieu, adieu, kind friends, adieu, adieu. I can no longer stay with you. I'll hang my harp on a weeping willow tree, and may the world well go with you, if he. He left me for a damsel dark, each Friday night they used to spark, and now my love, once true to me, takes that dark damsel on his knee. Fare thee well, for I must leave thee, do not let the parting grieve thee, and remember that the best friends must part. Adieu, adieu, kind friends, adieu, adieu. I can no longer stay with you, I'll hang my harp on a weeping willow tree, and may the word go well with thee, where will thee? Oh, dig my grave both wide and deep, put tombstones at my head and feet. Head and feet, and on my breast carve a turtle dove to signify I died of love, died of love. Fare thee well, for I must leave thee. Do not let the parting grieve thee, and remember that the best friends must part, adieu, adieu, kind friends, adieu, adieu. I can no longer stay with you, stay with you. I'll hang my heart on a weeping willow tree, and may the world go well with thee.
Thank you, Murray. Okay, back from Brooklyn, back to England again, and Anna and Ray.
This cross-channel travel is great, isn't it? Yes. Across transatlantic.
Cross ocean.
Right, we're going to play one of our own songs now, which is, this is a story of something that happened several years ago. When my mum, it was a little bit after my dad had died, and my mum was in the house by herself and feeling a bit despondent, as could be expected, and sort of needed something or someone to cheer her up. And something or someone came along who needed a hand. And this is the story of that. It's called Dinner for Two. And there's a refrain at the end of each verse that goes, both friends find life better now as their two worlds collide. Wild and free, a maverick he, suburbia his home. She was independent too, not afraid to live alone. And each one held inside a fierce and fiery pride. Both friends find life better now as their two worlds collide. Racing through the foggy streets, his amber eyes were bright. A speeding car, a dreadful crash, he fled into the night. No longer dignified to find a place to hide. Both friends find life better now as the two worlds collide. Shadow caught her eye. A wounded fox with straggly brush, thin and scared and shy. She quickly did decide her dinner to divide. Both friends find life better now as their two worlds collide. He still haunts the lanes and streets, strong again and free. But every day at 6 o'clock, he calls in for his tea. It fills her heart with pride
this lifeline to provide. Both friends find life better now as the two worlds collide. Both friends find life better now as the two worlds collide.
Thank you. That's dinner for two. I actually got to meet the fox once or twice, and literally you could set your watch by him. He would lurk at the bottom of the garden. Mum would look out and go, "Oh, it's about time then." Put some food out for him. He'd shoot down, hoover it up, and vanish. Okay, we're going to finish off with something very different. A bit of a sing along again. I'm not going to tell you the lyrics to the sing-along bit because it will be obvious once we get going. And there might be a couple of you who at this point know which song we're talking about. It was written by our good friend Tony Phillips. And it's the story of a young lad who is lured away to sea by the promise of fame and glory. It's folk music. It's not going to end well. The stories that I love the best from sailors when they're home on rest are stories tall as old oak trees that kept them sailing on the sea. Those sunburned men with smiling eyes, they boast of how they won that prize. With Frenchy's gold they took their ease, lived like lords, did what they pleased. Oh, they talked of cannon roaring loud and smoke so thick it seemed like cloud. It settled on that battle scene, hiding death behind a screen. Well, I know now that wasn't true, and red blood stained the sailors blue. No ghostly mist can hide away the lessons that I learned that day. I believed what I'd been told about the silver and the gold that lie in wait for boys like me when serving in the King's Navy. I believed what I'd been told and bought the lies that others sold and lost both legs below the knee when serving in the King's Navy. Here we go. What shall we do with a drunken sailor? What shall we do with a drunken sailor? What shall we do with a drunken sailor? Hooray, and up she rises. Hooray, and up she rises. Hooray, and up she bloody rises.
That's your bit.
Back then it was such a thing to serve my country and my king. I ran from home to volunteer on a three-mast privateer. Now I'm returned from overseas, there are no daydreams left for me. I curse those men with smiling eyes who took me captive with their lies. I believed what I'd been told about the silver and the gold that lie in wait for boys like me when serving in the King's Navy. I believed what I'd been told and bought the lies that others sold and lost both legs below the knee when serving in the King's Navy. What shall we do with a drunken sailor? What shall we do with a drunken sailor? What shall we do with a drunken sailor? Hooray, and up she rises. Hooray, and up she rises. Hooray, and up she bloody rises. I still see them every day. Lights hang upon each word they say. I see them, but they don't see me. I'm not the one they yearn to be. And I curse those men with smiling eyes. Their gray beards make them seem so wise. But there's no wisdom to be found when you're 6 feet underground. I believed what I'd been told about the silver and the gold that lie in wait for boys like me when serving in the King's Navy. I believed what I'd been told and bought the lies that others sold and lost both legs below the knee when serving in the King's Navy. So what shall we do with a drunken sailor? What shall we do with a drunken sailor? What shall we do with a drunken sailor? Hooray, and up she rises. Hooray, and up she rises. Hooray, and up she bloody rises. What shall we do with a drunken sailor? What shall we do with a drunken sailor? What shall we do with a drunken sailor? Hooray, and up she rises. Hooray, and up she rises. Hooray, and up she bloody rises. What shall we do with a drunken sailor?
Tony Phillips.
Wow.
Thank you for singing along.
It's lovely. That was truly lovely.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's one of those I wish I'd written that songs.
When you're old, the results are very good.
Yeah, I think we all thought that. When you get a room full of people literally bellowing out "She Bloody Rises," it really is got impact, that song, isn't it? Lovely song.
Yeah, you've been there, haven't you?
I've been there a few times.
Okay, wow. You ready?
I am.
Okay.
Beautiful day here in South Florida, mid-80s, and we got the blue skies with puffy white clouds. But I'm going to sing a song about some other type of weather, mainly a panhandle wind out of Texas, a cold one. And I knew this song from a Robin and Linda Williams album. And I looked to see who wrote it once, and I didn't realize Tom Paxton wrote it. I don't know if I ever heard Tom Paxton sing it. This is about the panhandle wind in Texas. There's a panhandle wind out of Texas tonight. Cold taste of snow on your tongue. We'll be bringing in firewood from Texas tonight. For the winter is wild and young. And the full moon and the fences surely be buried. Snow will be drifting and blown. There's a panhandle wind out of Texas tonight. Wise ones are staying to home. It's a cold wind and a loner like an old drunken gal. Till it seems to go wild, a half crazy whale. It's a wind without a panhandle wind, leaves only trouble behind. God knows where it comes from, couldn't be sure. One thing that's easy to tell, if it catches you out in the open, my friend, be certain it comes straight from hell. Though the fool who goes out in a panhandle wind is a fool with a lesson to learn. Cause the devil is riding that wind out.
go wild with a half crazy whale. It's a wind without mercy. A friend of mine, it's a panic in the wind. Leaves only trouble behind. Texas tonight, the cold taste of snow on your tongue. We'll be bringing in firewood to Texas tonight. For the winter, it's wild and young. And the full moon in the fences will surely be buried. Snow will be drifting in. It's a panhandle wind out of Texas tonight. It's a low wind and a loner, like an old drunken jam, till it seems to go wild, half crazy well. It's a wind without mercy, no friend of mine. It's a panhandle wind, he's only trouble behind.
I just got word that from my wife upstairs on the iPad that we may be making it down to Florida in November too, right around Thanksgiving. So you never know, you know. This tune is a variant of a bunch of tunes that were recorded by people like Little Son Jackson and Muddy Waters and B.B. King and Willie Dixon. It's impossible to really know who wrote these tunes. And so I won't even make an attempt to figure it out. Oh, and I was going to say, what Anna said before was very interesting. You know, it's really true, the whole thing with being able to jump back and forth across ponds and lakes and rivers and all that stuff is pretty cool. As Saul and Murray know, I've been doing synagogue services for a year and a half on Zoom, but I had a new experience this past week. I had a hearing before an administrative law judge at the New York State Division of Human Rights on Zoom. I still don't know what was going on, but whatever it is, you know.
Rock me, baby, rock me slow. Rock me, baby, one time before you go. Rock me, baby, hey, 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 come on and rock me, baby. You got to rock me, baby, one time before you go. Rock me, baby, rock me long. Rock me, baby, like your back don't have no bone. Rock me, baby, hey, hey, come on, rock me, baby. You got to rock me, baby, one time before you go. Thank you. sun goes down, the moon begins to rise. Sun goes down, the moon begins to rise. Come on and rock me, baby, till your sugar satisfied. Missed it, what it's all about. Rock me, baby, and you soon find out. Rock me, baby. Hey, hey, come on, rock me, baby. Rock me, baby, one time before you go. Sun goes down, the moon begins to rise. Sun goes down, the moon begins to rise. Come on and rock me, baby, till your sugar satisfies. I say this, rock me, baby, rock me slow. Rock me, baby, one last time before you go. Rock me, baby. Hey, rock me, baby. You got to rock me, baby, one time before you go. I said now, one last time. You got to rock me, baby, one time before you go.
Thank you.
It's great. That was great. Okay, I think Bill, you're next.
Yep, right. Well, like Donna earlier, I am in awe of the people around me here, so we just plod on and do what we do, don't we? But I'm going to be self-indulgent because I'm going to do the one I meant to do earlier. And by coincidence, it's another one that I'd virtually forgotten. And it was Mike Reeves this afternoon sitting on the train on Southend Pier who said, why don't we were thinking of what to sing because we sing going up and down on this pier train, you know. And Mike said, why don't you do that one about Southend Pier? And I thought, I've forgotten it, so we couldn't. But I've dug out some of my keywords that I've got a list of, and I've stuck them up there where I can almost see them. So we're going to try that. But it is self-indulgent. It's another one of mine. The song's short enough to have a quick explanation because you already know now that Southend Pier is so long. It's a mile and a third long, and it's got its own little train. And our ride today was historic because we're getting new trains next week. They're going to bring in a new carriage every day all through the week. And I think if they had about 100 carriages, then the train will only have to travel about 20 foot and then we can all get off because it will nearly take them. Anyway, I'm working on that. The reason this is by coincidence, another one I can remember when I wrote it, because I've written it down on the list of words here, and it was the 9th of October, 2005. And that was a Sunday night, and it says here at 10:45 was when Southend Pier last caught fire and had a jolly good blaze. And you know it's got a train. The reason it really took hold, it was a nice clear night, so there was no rain to help douse the flames once it got rolling. The tide was out, so they couldn't use the fire tugs to come along and pump water from the sea. They did have actually a mains water supply which fed the fire hydrants, but that was made of plastic and it burnt, so all the water got out, so they had no fire to actually try and douse it with. So it was really doomed from start to finish, that thing. And it was all quite exciting because they had a little pub there and chip shops and all manner of things, and
everything finished up in the sea. And the sort of history behind it is that was a Sunday night, and you had to wait to start getting all the news reports on the Monday to see if it was really serious and anybody had sort of died or got badly injured. And by Monday night, we found out it was fairly safe. Nobody was hurt. So that meant Tuesday morning was the time to write a broadside ballad in time to take La Jolla anchor on the Tuesday night, get there early, book an early slot, so you would be the first one to do the broadside ballad of Southend Pier burning down before some other bugger did it. So it was meant to be a one-off, but it tended to stick over the years. And yeah, like some of Anna's refrains and things, this has got something regular. It's got an incremental chorus, which you don't need to worry about too much. But people got into the habit of just yelling one word at a certain point. When it got to that point, everybody went, fire! And they banged the tables and create a great racket. And there was a time at the White Hart in Grays when the folk club there made such a noise. The people in the other bar thought it was a genuine fire and people had started to evacuate. And I think we nearly got evicted, but we got away with it in the end. So there we go. Anyway, that's a lot of stuff while I'm trying to focus on my words here. And yes, the death of Southend Pier. The sky was clear and the moon was bright on a mild October Sunday night. The tide was out and the sea was slight and the pier caught fire again. Oh, what a fuss and oh, what a fright when the pub and the chip shop caught alight. All of a sudden the birds took flight when the pier caught fire again. Oh, where was the sea when we needed water? Where was the weather when we wanted rain? It's made of wood, not bricks and mortar. You can't stop the fire and flame. Where was the sea when we needed water? Where was the weather when we wanted rain? It's done it again when it should an altar. Fire! Southend Pier's burnt down again. The poor old pier, it stands or floats, it falls to bits or it's rammed by boats. Now and then another blaze, just like in its glory days. The chip shop and the pub came down, and the railway station of great renown. Down it came with a crash and thud, down into the Southend mud. Where was the sea when we needed water? Where was the weather when we wanted rain? It was long and now it's shorter. Southend Pier's burnt down again. Where was the sea when we needed water? Where was the weather when we wanted rain? It's done it again when it should an altar. Fire! Southend Pier's burnt down again. Out on the beach on Monday morning, looking around as day was dawning, went to see what the tide brought in, a cask of beer and a bottle of gin, and down Thorpe Bay, by the huts, a case of ready salted nuts, two chip suppers on their plates, old age pensioners at special rates. Oh, where was the sea when we needed water? Where was the weather when we wanted rain? Told the firemen they should have called to Southend Pier electric train. Where was the sea when we needed water? Where was the weather when we wanted rain? It's done it again when it should an altar. Fire! Southend Pier's burnt down again. South and council in their chambers, doing things for which they're famous, carry on talking year on year, making plans for Southend Pier, like the phoenix from the ash, with lottery money and euro cash. In a year or two or three, it'll be back again, as good as new astride the sea. But oh, where was the sea when we needed water? Where was the weather when we wanted rain? Where was the railway station porter sailed away to the Isle of Grain? Where was the sea when we needed water? Where was the weather when we wanted rain? It's done it again when it should an altar. Fire! Southend Pier's burnt down again. The end.
Great.
Really good song, Bill.
Well, I thought it was quite a rubbish song at the time, but at least it was the first one in there, and that's the important thing, isn't it?
No, it was
I'm glad I asked for it.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay, Mike, it's your turn.
No, I said I'm not going to do another one. I've told Ed.
Well, okay, then, Ed, I believe it's you're next.
Okay. It's just a little lullaby I learned years ago. I can't remember where. Mm-hmm. head is too small for my tiredness. Bring me a hillside, a tree. Plant a cloud down under my head. Lord, blow the moon out, please. Rock me to sleep in my cradle of dreams, so I may slumber in peace. Place a cloud down under my feet. Lord, blow the moon out, please. It is too small for my tired little head. Bring me a hillside of trees. Place a cloud down under my head. Lord, blow the moon out, please.
I I'm going to do a song about what it's like when you get a wee bit older and you think about going back maybe for a little while to some of the places you knew when you were young. I was born and raised in Liberia on the west coast of Africa, and I've always wanted to go home at least for the next, for the last 70 years or so. But due to the coup d'etat, I've always hesitated to return there. At any rate, it's probably a good thing. But here's a song about finding places in your elderly days that you remember from your youth. Sandy bar ran so swift, locked in my memory, but the way things were, it's not the way things are. We used to swim in the crook of its arm in the summer heat, who can be blamed? Avoided the rapids as best as we could, never thought that that stream could be tamed. Long ago I gave up that riverside valley, traded cool leaves for towers of steel. Abandoned the vistas and valleys of childhood for the things that they told me were real. No more would I run with the speed of a colt cross the gravel down by waterside. horse with a twig, I threw it at the bed. Couldn't beat it, though God knows I tried. Now the river's not rotting as fast as it did. There's a dam there restricting the flow. And I don't run either as fast as I did. Guess that river and I have grown old. Oh, now it's strange in returning places of youth. You think your memory has made a mistake. Cause a place that once scared you with white water running has been turned by decree to a lake. Made me think about how too I smoothed out the wrinkles, made the waters as calm as you please. Made me think about how that old river and I were both happier when we ran free. Now the river's not rotting as fast as it did. There's a dam there restricting the flow. And I don't run either as fast as I did. Guess that river and I have grown old. I guess that river and I have grown old. Thank you very much.
Let's see the picture they have up here. Don't see it all, but the important thing, the song, well, we heard it and it was beautiful. That's the important thing.
Yeah. Oh, can I just say, by the way, so when I said earlier how I'm in awe of the people here, what I neglected to say was my musical ambition is to be Debbie and Ron.
They're coming up right now so you can hear them.
I thought the timing was about right, yeah.
Beautiful. Okay, Debbie and Ron, take it away.
Thank you.
All right, here's an old chestnut, as we say.
The next train song.
Another train song. Oh, the train is landing ocean to the wide Pacific shore. She's flying the flowing mountains all the new by the shore. Lady tall and handsome, she's known quite well by all. She's a regular combination now of a man and ball.
Jingle, rumble, and
election is April 1st, and Debbie Finer picked from where she's left it all. And as the race is over, the curtain's round him. We'll carry him home to victory on the Wabash Cannonball. The jingle from the land of the as he cries home, the woodland on the hillside is shown. See the mighty voice of the angry near the turf of all the world. Out through the jungle on the Wabash Cannonball. Out through the jungle on the Wabash Cannonball.
Okay. That's why I use cork back picks.
I've been talking to more lately. It's like, yeah, it's great. Old age is great. You know, everything's falling apart. My hands don't hold the picks anymore.
But my mandolin's out of tune.
All right.
And the moon is blue.
Okay, so we're gonna do another old. This is many versions, and actually, the original recording was by the Carter family in 1930, but let me see. What key do I do?
All right, now we got to find a key.
All right, here it is. Got it. Okay. So, all sing along with this. You all know it. This particular version is Woody Guthrie's version. Called the Worried Man Blues.
Just there I love. Yeah. Thanks, Bill. Thanks, Bill, for that comment. Much appreciated.
You're welcome.
And now the world is what we're waiting for, Terry.
No, thank you. Yeah, but Debbie, you're much better looking than Bill, so, you know, you're way ahead of him there, that's for sure. I know Bill of old. How many times do you find yourself sitting there with a song all prepared to do as you watch yourself coming round, and then here I go, then the person before you sings a song and you think, no, I'm going to change it. So that's exactly what I'm going to do. So I did this song last time I was here, in fact, which was in last July, a couple of months ago, but never mind. I'm going to do it. It's a kind of a homage to Woody Guthrie, and it just seems to follow that last lovely, lovely song. This world, and I've seen a lot of men. They rob you with a gun or a ballpoint pen. They say I pay you next week, but they never say when. Roll on, roll on, roll on. You don't get dirty, then you don't get paid. And you don't get paid but a dollar a day. And then the tax, the revenue, take it all away. Roll on, roll on, roll on. They take it away, and you just keep rolling on. I dig your fields and I water your vines. Put food on your table and a sparkling wine. But I wind up standing at the back of the line. Roll on, roll on, roll on. I worked your mines and I gathered your corn. Copper and iron up in Baltimore. I've been working for you since the day I've been born. Roll on, roll on. Since the day I was born, I just keep rolling on. And this land is your land. This land is my land. From California to the New York Island. Redwood forest to the Gulf Stream waters. This land was made for you and me. Slows, and it's a mighty hard road that my poor hand hold. And I slept all night in the trucks that I drove. Roll on, roll on, roll on. Now I worry all the time like I never did before. I never had a key to my own back door. 'Cause I ain't gonna home in this world anymore. Roll on, roll on, roll on. No, I ain't got no home, I just keep rolling on. Well, you don't miss
kiss the water till the well runs dry. You don't miss your friends till the day they die. They swear it's the truth, but you know it's a lie. Roll on, roll on, roll on. You know it's a lie, you just keep rolling on. Well, this land is your land, this land is my land. From Caledonia to the Holy Islands, from the Ashdown Forest to the inshore waters, this land is made for you and me.
Anna, that's lovely.
Okay, I'm now going to do the penultimate, as Tony says, and I'm wondering after I do it whether we can prevail on Terry to do an ultimate. Yes, Terry?
Yeah, I'm sure that's very nice of you, but there are lots of people here who can sing tonight, that's for sure.
Well, you don't show up that often, so you do come with experience for us.
Okay, yeah, thank you.
So I'm going to do a very short one. I just want, I just want to make the announcement that before I start, we'll be here again next week, same link, and hopefully everybody can show up, and we really enjoy this. February will be 2 years. If you could make it February, that would be us. We've been around at the year and a half mark now, and I think maybe we may be the longest running thing on Zoom. Okay, this song, it's older than me, it's older than everybody here, it's older than the United States of America. It was written in 1616 by a playwright called Ben Jonson. I learned it from my mother. She learned it when she was 10 years old in school, and it's a beautiful poem. But Ben Jonson was an English playwright, by the way. It goes like this. Drink to me only with thine eyes, and I will pledge with mine. Or leave a kiss within the cup, and I'll not ask for wine. The thirst that from the soul doth rise, doth ask a drink divine. But might I of Jove nectar sip, I would not change for thine. I sent thee late a rosy wreath, not so much honoring thee as giving it a hope that there it could not withered be. But thou thereon didst only breathe, and sendst it back to me. Since when it grows and spells, I swear, not of itself by thee. Everybody, drink to me only with thine eyes, and I will pledge with mine. Or leave a kiss within the cup, and I'll not ask for wine. The thirst that from the soul doth rise, doth ask a drink divine, but might I of Jove's nectar sup, I would not change for thine. Okay. Everybody for coming today. I mean, we have a wonderful group here, and I hope you keep coming back every week because I enjoy it so much, and I'm sure a lot of other people do. So, without any further ado, Terry, you're the man.
I wish you wouldn't build me up like that. So let's. But it's much appreciated to be here anyway. Let me get on with this. This is a song, I've did it before, but it was a year ago here, last October, I think. I kind of keep a record, so I try not to repeat. It's a song for all those pretty girls in chorus lines, the forgotten girls in chorus lines from musicals like 42nd Street. Sing to you tonight, Kitty. Who's gonna ease your troubled mind? Who's gonna turn out all the lights, my pretty? Put away your things and close the blind on all those pretty girls with a promise in their hearts, hanging on to every word he never said. Who's gonna sing to you tonight, Kitty, when you lay down your weary head? Gonna talk to you today, Kitty, and whisper words that almost rhyme, words that sparkle in the night, my pretty, but in the morning lose the shine. You rock a bye like a lullaby, baby, don't sleep tight before the dawn. And Angelo's and Max's every night. And who's gonna wake you in the morning, my pretty? Who's gonna break your heart tonight? With you tonight, Kitty, and lace your ice with Ballantine. Who's gonna walk you home tonight, my pretty, and sing to you a Broadway lullaby? Another day is dawning, and the milkman's on his way. The early train is waiting for a light. Who's gonna wait for you today, my pretty? Who's gonna sing to you tonight? Sing to you a Broadway lullaby. Baby, good night, the milkman's on.
his way. Well, sleep tight, baby. Sleep tight and let's call it a day. Thank you, Jerry, everybody. Oh, so good to see you all. Lovely. Thank you, folks.
The group, and let's say goodbye to everybody. Drive carefully.
Take care.
I really enjoy listening to this. I enjoy
seeing everybody.
Good night.
Thank you.
Thank you, everybody.
Good night, everyone. This was great.
Good night.
Come again.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.